There are a lot of autonomous system now everywhere in the world, and in particular in the ocean, the number, we had realized that the number of underwater vehicles is increasing and predicted to increase quite a bit. So the particular aspects that we're focusing on is twofold. The first one is trying to estimate the optimal path in the ocean, in particular focusing on time optimal, so how to go from point A to point B, where you have a lot of underwater vehicles that have all of these paths that they need to plan in an optimal time. Another aspect that we're working on is also minimizing energy, which becomes equivalent to traveling in optimal time if you travel at a nominal speed for underwater vehicles. One of the amazing things of this project, in a sense, is really the interdisciplinary character of the work. It involves fluid dynamics and ocean dynamics. It involves advanced numerics and computational schemes. And it involves a deep knowledge of estimation theory and control theory in particular, and also applied mathematics, in the sense, new equations that we have derived. If you think about examples for this new theory and algorithms that we developed, the simplest one is really the flow behind an island. So you have an obstacle, obviously the underwater vehicles cannot go through the obstacle, so they have to avoid it. And then they would have to also, they have eddies that form behind the island, and so they can utilize these eddies in the most efficient way, since the speed of the eddies can be larger at times than that of the vehicle. Similarly, if you have underwater vehicles that are released from a point and need to form a formation, let's say, of a triangle, and it's behind the exit of a strait, then you have eddies that form, and these vehicles are going to be entrained by the eddies, or at times avoid them, or at times go along the flow in order to try to reach the goal at the end. Another application is that if you try to discover ocean processes, then specific patterns allow you to extract the dynamics of the flow. Finally, you can also have regions that are forbidden in the ocean. So in that case, it's not really an obstacle. The water goes through the region, but you don't want the vehicle to go through that region for many different possible reasons. So these could be regions that the vehicles would not go, either for security reason or for pollution reasons, or etc. And so therefore we can add those as constraints, and those regions can change with time. And in this case, radar algorithm is also capable of dealing with this in an optimal and rigorous exact way. You could ask the question, why is this at all important, or why do we care in traveling in optimal time or minimizing energy, or why do we care to have all of these vehicles on the water, right? One of the main reasons is that the battery, right, of these underwater vehicles is limited, so meaning they cannot really travel on the water forever. There's also questions of biofouling that can damage the vehicles. So the concept of trying to minimize energy or to travel from one point to another point in optimal time, if you travel at nominal speed, is very important for many different applications, from societal needs to fisheries to protection and security, all the way to naval operation.